we're exploring caves and setting booby traps. That's right, it's the Goonies Never Say Die from Funko Games and Prospero Hall. In the most amazing game you ever saw, you'll play through 9 unique adventures that tell the story of the Goonies, brave yet bungling Oregon kids on the hunt for pirate treasure. In each adventure, one player takes on the role of the Goondock's master, or the GM. The GM acts as the narrator of the story and the keeper of secrets, revealing new information and exciting surprises as the adventure plays out. The GM also controls all the foes in the game and tries to stop the Goonies from completing their goal. The rest of the players take on the role of the intrepid Goonies. If they are able to work together and complete their goal before time runs out, they win the game. Setup begins with the game board in the center, with the GM player sitting on the side labeled Goondock's Master. Separate the tokens and dice and place them near the board along with the hourglass tile. Put the 4 sand tokens on the top of the hourglass. Separately shuffle and place the item deck and the treasure deck. Also place the 3 teenager cards face up. Then each Goonie player chooses which Goonie they'll play. If there's only one Goonie player, they play as 2 Goonies. Each Goonie has a placard and a figure. Each placard includes the character's name, art, health, maximum wishes, check dice, and special abilities. Players take their Goonies figure, a reference card, the number of wish tokens shown on their placard, and any special cards and tokens for that Goonie. The GM takes the GM screen and reviews the adventure guide, which contains all the information they'll need to lead their Goonies on their adventure. They should read through the adventure before playing, so they know what actions the Goonies can take that trigger new parts of the story. Then the GM makes their deck by shuffling the 24 basic GM cards with any special cards that apply to their current adventure. There aren't any special cards for the first adventure. Then the GM draws 1 GM card, takes 1 GM token for each Goonie in the game, and you're ready to go. The GM follows any special setup for the adventure, and lastly, sets up the game board. In the adventure guide, there's a map for each adventure showing all the possible rooms that the Goonies can explore. At the start of the game, the GM only sets up the starting room. Other rooms only get set up when a Goonie explores it. To set up the starting room, the GM places the start token and any other tokens shown in that room on the game board. Then they place any passages connected to the starting room and an unexplored token on each connected room. Place the Goonies figures in the starting room and then read the adventure's introduction and the Goonies starting goal out loud. For the first adventure, read the story on page 3 of the adventure guide first. Gameplay occurs in rounds, starting with the Goonies round and followed by a GM round. Rounds alternate until there's a winner. First up, the Goonies round. In most rounds, Goonies start by gaining a wish token and flipping their placard face up. But that's skipped in the first round of the adventure. Then each Goonie takes a turn in the order of their choosing. On a turn, they take up to 2 actions, as well as using any items, treasures, or special abilities they may have, and then flip their placard face down to show they've taken their turn. Before we talk actions, let's explain dice checks. Throughout the game, Goonies and the GM roll dice to check how successful their actions and abilities are. Each check has a type: strength, dexterity, or search. And most have a difficulty, which is the number of successes needed to pass the check. There may also be secret benefits to getting more successes that only the GM knows about. When a Goonie or a foe does a check, they roll the dice shown next to that check type on their placard or reference card. Each bone they roll is a success, and each skull they roll lets the GM gain a token. The smaller the die, the less likely you'll succeed. But there are ways to improve your chances. Players can spend tokens to upgrade dice, replacing their smallest die with the next size up. And Goonies can ask for teamwork from another Goonie in the same room to get an extra die. If the other Goonie agrees, they spend a wish token to give 1 die of the check's type, as shown on their placard, to the Goonie doing the check. Instead of getting teamwork from another Goonie, a Goonie can get help from a teenager. Flip a teenager card face down to add a die of the type shown on the card. Whenever the GM moves a sand token to the bottom of the hourglass, the Goonies choose a teenager card to flip face up again. A die given through teamwork cannot be upgraded, and players may never roll more than 3 dice for any reason. Here's an example. If I'm playing Mikey and I need to do a strength check, I'd roll 2 6-sided dice as shown on my placard. Let's spend a wish token to upgrade one of the dice to an 8-sided die. I could spend another token to upgrade the other die if I wanted. Now, because there's another Goonie in my room, I can also ask for teamwork. Sloth agrees, spins a wish token, and gives me a 12-sided die, since that's his dice size for strength checks. Okay, back to the actions Goonies can take. Move allows the Goonie to move to an adjacent room. Rooms connected by a passage are adjacent unless there's rubble blocking the way. If a Goonie moves through a dangerous passage, they must roll a dexterity check to get at least one success. Otherwise, they lose their action. When a Goonie moves into an unexplored room, the GM immediately sets up the new room according to the map in the adventure guide. Exploring a room may reveal other exciting surprises too. Search lets the Goonie investigate a token in their room that shows the search symbol. The Goonie tells the GM which token they are searching and then does a search check. They draw an item card, and if they rolled 2 or more successes, they also draw a treasure card. Items and treasures give the Goonies new actions and abilities. Attack can be taken against a foe in the same room and requires a strength check. Each success rolled deals 1 damage. When foes have as many or more damage than their health, they're removed from the board, and the Goonie that defeated them gains a wish token. Rest is a simple action to gain a wish token. Treasure actions are actions shown on treasure cards, and adventure actions include various other actions like removing rubble, escaping a trap, or other adventure-specific actions that the GM will reveal as the adventure plays out. After each Goonie has taken a turn, they may give any items or treasures to other Goonies in their room, because sharing is caring. Then, the Goonies round ends with all Goonies discarding down to 2 treasures and the number of wish tokens shown on their placard. During the GM round, the GM does the following in order. Gain 1 GM token, easy peasy. Activate foes. Each foe on the board may take a move action, and after the foes are done moving, each foe may take an attack action. Move and attack actions follow the same rules for foes as for Goonies, but foes cannot enter unexplored rooms, aren't affected by pit tokens, flooded tokens, or dangerous passages, and each foe must attack a different Goonie if there are multiple in the room. Next, the GM draws a GM card. Then, they may play a GM card from their hand. They can also spend GM tokens to draw or play additional cards in any order, 1 per token. Most GM cards have 2 abilities, but only 1 can be used at a time. The GM gets to use the top ability when playing the card on their turn, and uses the bottom ability when the card is played on a Goonie's turn, but it can only be played when the specific condition is met. One of the most important abilities on GM cards are end is nigh rolls, indicated by an hourglass symbol. When played, the GM takes 3 6-sided dice. They can upgrade them if they want, and then roll. If they get 2 or more successes, they move a sand token down to the bottom of the hourglass tile, and the card is discarded. If they get less than 2, the card is shuffled back into the GM deck. When the GM is done playing cards, they discard down to 5 cards, and the GM round ends. Rounds continue with the Goonies and the GM alternating until the GM starts a GM round with all 4 sand tokens on the bottom of the hourglass, or the Goonies complete their objective. But the Goonies' starting goal, the one that the GM read at the start of the adventure, is not their final objective. As you play the adventure, different actions will trigger new elements of the story, which the GM will share aloud. At a certain point, the GM will reveal the Goonies' true objective and what they need to do to win. If the Goonies aren't sure what to do next, they can ask the GM to repeat their starting goal and then keep exploring and searching for clues. And that's the basics of The Goonies Never Say Die. I'm Becca Scott, this is Geek and Sundry, and you can find all kinds of other how to play videos right here on the channel. See you next time.